Project Economy News tonight. Chocolate, pretty sweet. So sweet, one Des Moines chocolate maker is having a hard time keeping up with demand. So, Steve Karlin, which one is it?
Well, Stacy, it's Chocolatery Stom. The Dutch chocolate maker started in 1997 with a small kiosk in Valley West Mall. Now it's expanding so far and so fast, the demand is increasing so much, it's bought a much bigger building.
In 2001, when Chocolatery Stom opened its first brick-and-mortar store on Ingersoll Avenue with its fancy European flair, some Des Moines chocolate lovers were hesitant to come in because they thought the prices would be too high.
My family philosophy has always been reasonably priced, more volume, because that's a win-win.
So much of a win-win, the company went from 7 stores this year to 10 in 3 states. There are plans to open another 4 next year, and 5 more the year after that.
The only thing that on the counter that still comes from Holland is the sugar-free.
Company president Ton Stom is a third-generation chocolate maker from Holland.
Well, we've been doing this since 1913.
99% of what he sells is made above the Ingersoll store. But his company is expanding so far, so fast, Stom has run out of room. So after Easter, he's moving his production facility to this now vacant building on the city's south side.
Total square footage of this building is 20,000.
Sounds like chocolate is a very sweet growth industry.
But chocolate is a luxury, so in this bad economy, wouldn't you think that it would be one of the first extravagances struck from the list?
No, according to customers.
It's not a luxury, it's a necessity. It's part of your food group.
And not according to Stom.
It's not a $50,000 car. It's not a $4,000 vacation. It's a box of chocolate.
He says chocolate is an indulgence many people feel they can still afford.
Because good is good. Good doesn't change.
And Chocolatery Stom is not done. The Dutch company's 100th anniversary is coming up in 2013, and they plan to have a total of 25 stores in the United States by then.
Because what the world needs is more chocolate.
I agree.
Yes. Thanks, Steve.